You need anything? No bathroom, no nothing? No, a cookie or something? Another sandwich?
No.
Okay.
They'll be with you shortly.
Hey, bud. Do you need anything? There's another sandwich out there. You sure?
Mm-hmm.
You ate that whole pizza the other night. You sure you don't want another sandwich? All right. It's going to be just a bit, okay?
Am I going to be at school before school ends?
Probably not. I mean, we're at 2:30 already. And school's over at, what, 3?
3:05.
3:05, yeah. No.
What time will this be done?
Well, we're pretty much done. You know, we may have a couple follow-up things to ask you, but it's pretty much done.
Yeah.
We had mentioned to you that we'd like to maybe go out to the property so you can point out some of these things and where some of this stuff was. Okay?
Okay.
Brendan.
Go ahead.
What do you think's going to happen? What do you think should happen right now? You know, obviously, that we're police officers, okay? And because of what you told us, we're going to have to arrest you. Did you kind of figure that? What's coming? For what you did, we can't let you go right now. The law will not let us. And so you're not going to be able to go home tonight. All right?
Does my mom know?
Your mom knows.
Your mom is here, okay? Would you like to talk to her?
Yeah.
Do you have it before we bring her in? Do you have any other questions right now? You do understand that you're under arrest now?
So could I call my girlfriend and tell her that I couldn't come today?
We'll give you an opportunity to do that, okay? Did you kind of, I mean, honestly, after telling us what you told us, you kind of figured this was coming? Yeah?
This is only for one day, or?
We don't know that at this time. But let me tell you something, Brendan. You did the right thing. Okay? By being honest, you can at least sleep at night now, because I'm sure you had some difficulty with that. So you did the right thing here by telling us what happened. Okay? Just remember that in the future, okay? You need to be honest.
Your cooperation and help with us is going to work in your favor. I can't say what it's going to do or where you're going to end up, but it's going to work in your favor. And we appreciate your continued cooperation. We talked to your mom about going out to the house and going in the house and getting a few items, and about you going out there with us and her and pointing out those areas that we wanted you to point out. Is that all right?
Do you know where those shoes are that you were wearing that day? Those red shoes?
I think they're in the closet.
Okay, what about the jacket?
In the closet. Okay.
All right, we'll have your mom come in for a few minutes, okay?
Make you do it. And I would have walked out. That's what I would have did. Thank you. Why didn't you just tell him no? Huh?
Mm-hmm.
You knew it was wrong. Right? Do you know you can't come home? Do you know where you're going?
How long is it though?
I don't know. I do not know. Do I have to get him an attorney? Or will they do it for me?
The court will assign one for him, or the state will pay for his attorney if he can't pay for it. But obviously you have a right at any time to try and get him one or get him one.
I tried for a public defender not too long ago and I couldn't get it because I've got a house.
Well, there's different ways that they determine, you know, based on what you've been arrested for and stuff like that. There's different levels of money that you need. They don't determine. I don't know what that is or how they determine that.
You can be okay. Are you sure? Look at me. Why didn't you tell me? Stuff like that is not no secret. I don't care if he told you, if he said to keep it a secret, it's still not a secret. I don't keep secrets from you. Do I? Don't worry about my belly. I haven't eaten in 2 days.
I didn't even hear it. Did you want a sandwich, Barb?
No.
If we have some here.
No. I'd probably just throw it up anyhow. Am I going to be able to see him later on? After he gets where he's got to go?
I don't know on their policies and when they allow visitation and stuff like that. We could talk with Mark. He's going to know Sheboygan's policies or whatever. With Drew knows, it's probably a good chance, but I just don't want to say right now. Hello, Tom here. Good, how are you?
Hi.
for tomorrow?
What? I said, why?
Okay.
What did he do to you to make you do it? Did he force you to do it?
All right, if we go in tomorrow and I think we need someone, I'll call you, all right?
Huh?
Yeah. All right, thanks. Bye.
Huh?
You don't want to.
What?
You don't want to.
Regretting it now? You had a whole life ahead of you, Brendan. Just because he's so demanding doesn't mean you gotta do the stuff he says. Right?
Where am I going?
What do you think you're going?
Oh.
You're going to juvie. That's where you're going. To a juvie jail. About 45 minutes away.
Question.
What's that?
What happened if he says something like his story is different, but he says he admits to doing it?
What do you mean?
Like, if his story is like different, like I never did nothing or something.
Did you? Huh?
Not really.
What do you mean, not really?
They got to my head.
Huh?
I didn't say anything.
What do you mean by that? I have a question for you, Stu. Is there any way that I can talk to him? Not him. The other one.
As in Steve, you mean?
Yes.
The only way we could have you talk to him is if he calls you or if it's, you know, you go there for visiting.
I won't go there to visit.
Okay. That's the only way. I have no other way of, you know, I can't hook you up to him or anything like that. I'm not allowed to do that. If he calls you, okay, you can do what you want. Or if you go there for visiting, you know, that's up to you.
Were you pressuring him?
Who are you talking about?
Him.
What do you mean pressuring him?
When talking to him.
No, we told him we needed to know the truth. We've been doing this job a long time, Barb, and we can tell when people are telling the truth. And in my opinion, he'd never be able to live with himself if he didn't tell somebody. There's no way he couldn't live with that. Nobody could live with that. And I think Brendan knows that. Brendan, need you to use the bathroom or anything?
When are you going out to my house then?
As soon as we can leave here, we'll go out there. I don't think we're going to bring Brendan out there though. I just don't think that's a good idea. I don't think he needs to be exposed to that area out there anymore. Not gonna do him any good.
So what you're saying is if when he gets out, it wouldn't be a good idea for him to be there at all?
I can't tell you where for you guys to live, but what do you think? Do you think it's a good idea for him to be next for this stuff
occurring? I don't want to be there, but I can't afford another place.
I know.
I mean, that $80,000 I owe yet.
I understand. It's a shitty, shitty spot to be in.
And nobody's going to buy it.
You're in a bad spot, and I wish I had some answers for you. If there's something I can do to help you, I certainly will. Looking to move in the house.
I can't afford it.
Well, who knows? You don't even know what it'll cost. Depends on where you...
It's quite a bit. An extra $16,000 for another basement. So what did you all help him with? Can I ask? Will you tell me? Brendan? Did you do it willingly? Huh? He did tell me one time, Stephen, he told me that probably one or two of my kids would not graduate.
Stephen told you that?
Yeah. This was before this all even happened, so he must have had it all planned.
Very possible. Very possible.
You don't know how much hatred I got right now.
You're right, I don't. I can only imagine. I can't even put myself in your shoes, Barb. I can't.
My oldest son is gonna flip. I can't even tell him. I can't.
I think you better, because...
I can't. He's on a heart monitor now.
This is gonna be on the media tonight.
God.
There's no way to stop it.
He's not going to be on, is he?
Brendan?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, they can't anyhow.
No, he's not going to be on.
How long do we have to stay here?
Well, as soon as you guys are done talking.
No, he's not talking too much, so.
Okay. You know, I can leave you alone, but this is all recorded and videotaped. You understand that?
I don't care.
Okay. Do you want to be left alone with him for 5 minutes? Or it doesn't matter at this point?
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I just don't know if I'm going to be able to handle it.
You have to. Barb, you have to. You've got other children you've got to worry about.
I know.
And you've got Brendan to worry about, too. Brendan's going to need you through this.
Water, Brendan?
Brendan? My name is Dennis Jacobs. I'm a detective of Mantua County. Do you have any weapons or anything on you?
Just some stuff that I can give to my mom, like a CD player and that.
That wouldn't be a weapon, though. Do you have like a little pocket knife, anything like that?
No.
Can you stand up? I just want to pat you down real quick, just to make sure. Well, that's nothing that's going to hurt me. Okay, that's fine. Okay. But nothing else in your pockets at all? Okay. You have a shirt, you have a pocket up here?
No.
Okay, you can have a seat. Yeah, you can put it back in your pockets too if you want. It's up to you. Whatever you want to do. Actually, if you want to listen to your headphones, you can go ahead and do that too.
Brendan? Here's what's going to happen. Okay, we're going to take you downstairs, and they're going to fingerprint you and stuff here. Okay? And then you'll be taken over to down to Sheboygan County Jail. Okay? So, is that yours?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you have in your pocket? Only Christmas. All right, well, we go. Okay? Bring that along.
Are we going outside?
Sorry?
Are we going outside?
No.